Hi guys, welcome to my channel. This tutorial is great for absolute beginners. I'm going to show you how to crochet a Christmas stocking. And there is this loop, so you can hang it somewhere. The length of Christmas stocking is 30 centimeters and the width is 11 centimeters. You will need for this project chenille yarn. I picked etrophil. You can pick any chenille yarn. This is 100 grams. It's 100% polyester. And you will need one skein of each color. So you will need two colors. And also fluffy yarn from YarnArt. Pair of scissors, 5mm crochet hook, 6mm crochet hook, and stitch markers. We are going to start from upper part of stocking, so make a slip knot and then chain 26. Use 6mm crochet hook. Now we are going to make circle from this chain. So insert your hook into the first chain and make a slip stitch. Be careful, it shouldn't turn it. And now you can start next round with chain one and then finish the round with a slip stitch. But I will working around, so I'm going to make one single crochet in very first chain. And make one single crochet in each chain around. So you will have in this round 26 single crochets. So continue working one single crochet in each stitch all the way around and make 12 rows together. I have done 12 rows or 12 rounds and I'm going to finish this round, so make slip stitch in the next stitch and let's start next round. So chain one and make one single crochet in each stitch all the way around. So you can pause the video and meet me back again at the end of this round. And now we have to finish the round by slip stitch. So we have done 13 rounds. We made the last round like this because we want to have straight edge. Now use stitch marker and count 13 stitches. Thirteen stitches we will crochet and change the color. Chain one by the white color of yarn and then make one single crochet in each stitch to the stitch marker. And I'm going to hide the tails, both tails, behind my work. So you must have 13 single crochets together. Now chain one, turn your work and make one single crochet in each stitch to the end of this row. Start in the very first stitch and make one single crochet. Make one single crochet in each stitch across. Chain one, turn and repeat it again. So start in very first stitch and make one single crochet. Then make one single crochet in each stitch across. Now you need your stitch markers and we will count. And we will count 6 stitches from the left side. And then use stitch marker. And then count 6 stitches from the left side and use stitch marker. So we are going to make the shape of heel. Chain one, turn your work. And now start in very first stitch and make one single crochet. In the next stitch, make one single crochet. In the next stitch, make one single crochet. In the next stitch, make one single crochet. And over here, make one single crochet. So we have done 5 single crochets. Now you can remove the stitch marker and make 2 single crochets together. Then you can remove the second stitch marker as well and make 1 single crochet. Now chain one and turn your work. Make 1 single crochet in very first stitch. And now 2 single crochets together. In the next stitch, make 1 single crochet. Chain 1, turn your work, and now make 1 single crochet in the next 2 stitches. Start in very first stitch like always. Now make 2 single crochets together. Insert your hook into the last stitch, and now insert your hook over here and make 2 single crochets together. Then in the next stitch make 1 single crochet. Chain 1, turn your work and then make 1 single crochet in next 3 stitches. Now make 2 single crochets together. So insert your hook over here, grab the yarn, pull it through and then insert your hook over here and finish 2 single crochets together. In next stitch make 1 single crochet. Chain 1, turn your work and now make 1 single crochet in next 4 stitches. In very last stitch insert your hook, grab the yarn, pull it through, then insert your hook over here and make two single crochets together. Then make one single crochet in next stitch. Chain one, turn your work and repeat it again. So make one single crochet in the next five stitches. And then make two single crochets together. So this is last decrease on this side. Now just chain one, turn your work and make one single crochet in next six stitches. Oh, I said six, but it will be just five single crochets. And then make last decrease on this side as well. And make a slip stitch. You can cut the yarn, and we have done the heel. So I made slip stitch, so you can pull the tail through the loop, and now take the blue color of yarn again, and let's make the rest of stocking. Insert your hook over here in this stitch. The first blue stitch, pull it through and chain one. And now make one single crochet in the next five stitches. But the stitches are not visible because we are on the side. So make five single crochets on this side. You should make one single crochet in each row of the heel. So just count, and on the top of heel make one single crochet in each stitch. There are stitches, so in each stitch make one single crochet. And I'm hiding both tails behind my work again because it's more comfortable for me and less work at the end of the project. And then make again five single crochets on the other side of a heel. So find the stitch or the space where you can make one single crochet, and you should make one single crochet in each row of the heel. And now I'm going to decrease this part, so make two single crochets together. And then continue working one single crochet in each stitch to the other side of the corner of heel. If you will have any question, just write me here below the video, or you can write me on my Instagram profile at Thomas Sheep. So we are nearly at the end of the round and we have to decrease again. So make two single crochets together and then make slip stitch in the first stitch. And I will not start next round with chain one and I will not finish the round with a slip stitch. So I'm going to work in a round. So make one single crochet in very first stitch and then make one single crochet in each stitch all the way around. Make two more rounds and then decrease these two corners again and then make six more rounds without decrease. So I have done 10 rounds of single crochets and now just finish the round with a slip stitch and we are going to start new round, so chain one and make one single crochet in next stitch and make one single crochet in each stitch all the way around. So I am just making the edge straight. And now you have to finish the round with a slip stitch. So we made 11 rounds of single crochets and we have decreased two times in two rounds. Now take white color of yarn, chain one and then make one single crochet in each stitch all the way around. And I'm hiding both tails behind my work like always, so you can follow me if you want. And you can pause the video and then meet me back again at the end of this round. And I finished the round with a slip stitch and now in next round we are going to decrease. So make two single crochets together and then make one single crochet in the next five stitches. One, two, three, four, and five. Now decrease again, so make two single crochets together. So this is second decrease and then make one single crochet in next five stitches. Then decrease again, so make two single crochets together. It's third decrease and then make one single crochet in the next five stitches. And in this round you just have to decrease four times, so it doesn't matter if you will count five stitches between decreasing or not, just decrease four times in this round. And I have decreased four times, then I had three stitches left. So one single crochet in three stitches after fourth decreasing. And now we are going to start next round and make just one single crochet in each stitch all the way around. So this round is without changes. And now we have to decrease again. So decrease first two stitches. So make two single crochets together. Next round start with two single crochets together. Then make one single crochet in next two stitches. Then make two single crochets together. One single crochet in next two stitches. Two single crochets together. One single crochet in the next two stitches. Two single crochets together. One single crochet in next two stitches. then two single crochets together, and then make one single crochet in the next two stitches. So we have decreased 5 times in this round. Next round, decrease the first stitch, so make two single crochets together, then make one single crochet in next stitch, then decrease again, then make one single crochet in the next stitch, then decrease again. So you will make two single crochets together every second stitch all the way around. Then you can make two single crochets together till the end, till the hole is closed, but I'm going to use yarn needle from now because it will make better shape of end of stocking. So use yarn needle and just sew every stitch like this around. So go from outside, then from inside, then from outside, and like this you can close the hole of the stocking. Just pull it and tighten it and make a few stitches more and then just hide the end of the yarn. Now let's make the upper part of stocking. So use fluffy yarn and I'm going to use both tails, so I will use double yarn. Take 6 mm crochet hook, use double yarn because it will be better work and it will be nicer edge. It will be thicker edge and it will look nicer. So insert your hook somewhere here, pull the yarn through, chain one and just make one single crochet in each stitch around and work slowly with this yarn because it's fluffy yarn, it's harder work with this yarn, so be patient and just work slowly. And I'm hiding both tails behind my work again like always. So continue working one single crochet in each stitch all the way around. Then meet me back again. And we have to join the round with a slip stitch. So make a slip stitch in the first stitch. And the second round will be a little harder, but don't worry, you can do it when you will work slowly. So chain one and make one single crochet in each stitch all the way around again. And I'm going to make two more rows, so together I will have 3 rows of single crochets. So I will finish the round with a slip stitch and start the third round with chain one. And now let's make the loop for hanging. So now we are going to use the smaller crochet hook, 5 mm crochet hook. Insert your hook in the middle somewhere here and under the single crochet, pull it through and I'm going to make chain 11. It's up to you how long you want to have your loop for hanging. And I will just sew it like this. If you want to have thicker the loop for hanging, just make one more row. So you will start in the second chain and make one single crochet in each chain to the end, and then you can sew this end to the stocking. So I'm going just cut the yarn and pull it through like this, and then I will sew it to the stocking and hide all tails, all ends of the yarn inside the stocking. And that's all from me. If you like the video, put a thumb up, subscribe my channel for more videos, and share and comment the video. So, have a great day and see you soon. Bye bye.